今年是台湾关系法45周年，这几十年来，包括美国政府跟国会都透过台湾关系法对台湾提供实质的帮助。那台湾关系法也是印太和平稳定、台湾安全的定海神针。那特别是这几年来，美国国会透过国防授权法案，那对台湾的国防国安的安全，那么也提供了美国跟台湾各项的军事合作、教育训练等等都非常帮助。那另外美国我们也感谢美国总统拜登啊，用特别拨款的权利啊，今年2024年也提供给予台湾3亿美元的无偿军事融资，这对整个台湾的国家安全或是台海的和平稳定都有莫大的贡献。我和副总统当选人萧美琴大使在5月20号就要宣誓就职，我非常期待未来台湾能够持续得到美国的支持跟合作，让台湾能够更加的安全，印太能够更加的和平，台海也能够因此而更加的稳定。未来我们也会致力于经济跟产业的发展，不仅仅造福台湾人民，也能够在国际的繁荣上面扮演正面积极的力量。
Good morning, and thank you, President-elect Lai, for hosting our delegation and your efforts to maintain a robust relationship with the United States as you embark on your new role as leader. Taiwan is a key U.S. partner in the Indo-Pacific, both through a strong security cooperation and economic ties. The delegation is here to show Congress's continued support for our partnership. We will continue to assure our colleagues. This includes a strong Taiwan maritime strategy and how we can work together on shared goals to counter China on their increasingly aggressive actions in the region. Part of our visit will be to spend time with U.S. personnel to better understand how close the relationship is and what we can do to further the quality of the relationships. Thank you, and again, congratulations on your election, and I look forward to our discussion.